Good afternoon to you. Thank you for joining us here at the Jinyang Cultural and Sports Centre Natatorium. We are in Chengdu, Western China. And it's another day of diving, another day of competition for these Fisu World University Games. Heating up nicely. The women's 3 meter synchronized springboard final is what we are looking forward to. And these are the divers who will be battling it out. So, of course, women's synchronized, a pairing of Jia Chen, already a gold medalist, of course, in the women's 1 meter springboard event. She is from Chengdu University, linking up with Rulin Yang, experienced diver as well. Back to Jia Chen. This is a reverse half a somersault pike. As I mentioned, all of these dives in this second round will have a degree of difficulty of 2, and then we enter the more complicated rounds. Well, the contingent, the Chinese contingent, getting bigger as we go along. But that is, again, a very smooth effort there from the two Chinese divers. And Rulin Yang, 23 years of age, studying at the Shandong Sport University. But it's Chengdu zone. Jia Chen is just doing the business, 52.8. Even better than their first dive. Malaysia's long and on, reverse half in a pike position. It's a good dive, it's a very good dive. Very happy with that. They started with 49.2. Currently in second. And they'll get a good score for that. Again, they'll be up, closing in on 50 points. Yeah, 48.6, and totally justified as well. And there we have it, the end of round two. Jia Chen of Chengdu with Yang, her team at 105 points. They've got a 7.2 point advantage over the Malaysian duo on Bong and Ong. Jia Chen, Rulin Yang. This has got a DD of 3. We enter the third round, which means business. The business period. It's an inward 2.5 pike position. Yeah, that's a stunning dive. And the thumbs up. Plenty of appreciation. The fans enjoying that. Look at that, perfect unison. Maybe missing a little bit, just Rulin Yang. Just coming over the top marginally. Won't have lost too many points. It's still gonna be a very good score, 75.6. And as I said, the degree of difficulty increasing now as we enter round three, which means that some of these big dives are gonna be, well, more complicated, more technical. For Xylem Fowler with a forward 2.5 pike. 2.4 the DD. She was working so hard, Jacqueline Fowler, just to get herself into that position. Just see that there was lacking a little bit of synchronization on that occasion. Execution wasn't bad for the two divers. Point of entry. The weakest link there for Jacqueline Fowler. Studying at the USA, of course, and it's a forward 2.5 pike, 2.4 for Malaysia's Bong and Ong. It's a good dive, it's a good dive. Entry just letting them down. They will lose points, but should be looking at around about 60 points. They'll just lose a bit of ground on the Jia Chen and Rulin Yang. Good execution. And you can just see that Ke Ying Ong just coming over the top there. And obviously, the swish. And there we go, 50 points. Just under 49-68. Fourth coming into this, Hyun Jung, Hyunju Ko. It's an inward 2.5 in the tuck position, 2.7. Opportunity for them to just move up the rankings, put a bit of pressure on the Chinese pair. Could have done with a little bit more strength with takeoff, just to give them a little bit of extra air and height. That would have been a bit better. Synchronization. Lacking, but it really was Hyunju Ko who suffered when she was coming out. 43.74. Bailey Davenport. And Jenna Douglas. Jenna Douglas studying at Rutgers University in New Jersey. Originally from Cape Town. Would have loved to have seen that completed. It was well executed. It's coming out of the final rotation. It was a little bit of an issue for Bailey Davenport. You can see with the point of entry. Squeezing, need to get that head. And on the kind of real tuck position and then reach out. There's so many mechanics. Just see the reaction there. She knows it. Santos Maria Bonfando Santos Mora. This is a 2.70D. It's an inward 2.5 tuck. So the same dive as the South African pair. Well, it's a good dive, you know, and they're working well together. Just remember, a lot of these divers, they have not dived before they've actually arrived here in China. It's the same for the Americans, just coming together on arrival and getting the preparation. Well, unfortunately for Maria, she just had a little bit of an issue on entry. So she will lose points with that, but 48.6. La Ceneroni, Matilda Borello. And it's forward 2.5 with a twist in pike position. Big DD, it's up to 3. Oh, battling hard to try and get all of that dive in and then just come out and get the right entry. And you can obviously see that Mathilde was suffering there just at the very end. Battling to get her legs into that vertical position and is squeezing hard on entry. 55.8 because of the difficulty. It was a dive that picked up some useful extra points there. And after round 3 of 5, it's Jia Chen and Ruilin Yang with 180. They move 33 points ahead. Kimberly Camping Wong and Kei Ying Ong back in second. Lecce Noroni, Tilborello in third position. And to the top we go once again. Now this is a forward 3.5 rotations in that pike position, 3.1 DD. This is the most complicated technical dive in their repertoire. Well, it's absolutely fantastic. That is just, they're in a class of their own. Jia Chen diving with such panache. And seeing Ruilin Yang matching what she's doing just tells us what they're up to here. And they've got a plan, and it is all about clinching gold. Sophia Vizile, the 20-year-old from the University of South Carolina, begins to add to a bronze medal. Jacqueline Fowler. It's a back 2.5 tuck, 2.8. Well, entry suffered, but the technical part of the dive. See, from that angle, when you look at it, okay, the issue was coming out of that final rotation, but 44.52. They most definitely are enjoying themselves here in Chengdu. Kim Lubong carrying on. It's an inward 2.5 tuck, 2.7. Currently second. Going to try and improve on the 147.48. More than 112 points behind the Chinese pair. Dive. Showing great consistency, the Malaysian pair. And having seen what they achieved at the Asian Games, you can just see that there's trying to spill that fine form into Chengdu for this one event that they're taking part in. It's just the only one that they've decided to compete in. And, entry synchronization was a little bit off, 53.46. So up to the 200 point mark they go. Tae Yeonjung, Hyunju Ko, of the Republic of Korea. It's the back 2.5 tuck position. We've got a 2.8. Got a good chance of just moving up into the top three. And they might just do it with that. It's a good solid reaction. And a good solid reaction coming from their coach. Ko Byung-jin will be one happy man there, because that's 55.44. And they do move up into the third position behind the Malaysian pair. South Africa's Davenport and Douglas forward 2.5 with a twist. It's a 3DD. Big dive. Will that be a big score to follow? You know, that wasn't too bad. You can see how they're working really hard to just improve. Again, divers that haven't spent too much time together. If they get 50 points, they'll be happy. 47.7. Ana Santos. Maria dos Santos Moura, forward 3.5 tuck, 2.8. They do have a chance to push themselves up onto the podium. Again, that's good work. Will that be enough for them to get a good score? Yeah, I think that Maria had a few issues there. Anna coming around, working hard, reaching to find the point of entry. Alecchia Neroni, Matilde Borrello, it's a back 2.5 pike, TD of 3. Currently third. Good dive the last time around. Well, that's good. Let's just have a look at the synchronization. A little bit off with the timing, as you can see there. In terms of execution, good dive. Entry suffered marginally, but more than 50. Execution was good on both sides, so the individual judges that have got one, each diver there, will give them points, 54. And, well, the Italians keep that bronze medal with just over 12 points ahead of Dan Yeonjung and Hyunju Ko. But at the top, it's Xie Shen, Rulin Yang, ahead of Kimberly Camping Bong and Ke Ying Ong. We go back to the top. It's no time for us to see where this is going to head off into, of course, because it's round five and the DD here, three, forward two and a half. There's a twist thrown in a pike position. That's going to be difficult to beat. They're going to be difficult to beat. And if they get themselves at least 40 points, which they will, then they're pretty much guaranteed a gold medal. And I would definitely say they're guaranteed a gold medal. They're going to get more than that as well. This is going to be up in the 70s. Lacking synchronization at times during that during flight. Entry was good, it's always good. They work so hard on that. 71.1, so 330.75. And that's pretty much an unassailable lead. Now, Sophia Vizile and Jackie Fowler would love to cap off this performance with a good solid dive. It's an inward 2.5 tuck on 2.7. Plenty of points up for grabs. The judges' position, they'll look at that and say that's not bad at all. That's synchronization lacking. Sophia just coming out quite quickly. And the entry's not that good. But smiling faces of Sophia and Jacqueline Fowler. Loving every single moment here. 46 points there. Momentarily into second position. Now they're in the silver medal at the moment. Kimberly Bong, Kei Ying Ong. It's a back 1.5 with 1.5 twists in a free position, 2.4. It's a very nice dive. And that's going to give them lots of good points there. That's a perfect way to finish. Great strength with the takeoff. Good rotation, good execution. Entry not ideal, but still, it's going to give them a good score. And I think that they're going to lock down that second, that silver medal position with that. 56.88. Lovely smiling moment there for the two girls from Malaysia. Congratulations, Kimberly Bong out with injuries for, plagued with injuries for a couple of years. Now back in business. Daeon Young, Hyunju Ko, it's a back 1.5 with 1.5 twists. Free position, 2.4. They're in fourth position. Good dive, very good dive. Now, let's do our mathematics. Need more than 71 to get themselves into the silver medal position above the Malaysian pair, and it's not going to happen on this occasion. There's a few issues with that dive. Yeah, 48.96 into third position for the duo from the Republic of Korea. The last three pairs now, and we start with the South African pairing of Bailey Davenport, Jenna Douglas. 2.8, the DD, it's good. It's a back 2.5 rotations in the tuck position. What a technical dive this one. Good to finish off on a high. And they will finish off with a smile on their face. You see that Jenna Douglas entry not that good, but it's going to be a good 51.24. Congratulations to the two South Africans, smiling and happy days, and a nice moment with their coach. They've very proud, Nicole Gillis. Now let's see what Ana Santos and Maria dos Santos Moura can do here. Alvarado, Faculty of Brasilia. It's a forward 2.5 with a twist pike 3. Oh, she saved it so well, didn't she? Maria Bonfim dos Santos Moura. And, well, she won't be happy. Just look at her foot position. She was so close in, well, having a fall, but she did save herself from getting any injury. But, of course, after that, the dive, fighting to try and keep her balance with the final takeoff move. 34.2 points. It's okay. This is... no one's been hurt, and it's just about enjoying it. That's fine, 34.2, 213.136. You know, it's they'll get back to the pool and start diving and just improving on that. It's a reverse 2.5 pike for our final pairing of Elettra Neroni, Matilde Borello. It's a 3DD, they're currently third. Well, will they get enough points? That's the big question. They need 37 points, basically, to move into the bronze medal position. And they're both off there, and it's going to be a tricky one. But they might have done it. They might just get it because of the DD. Because they'll get... if they do, they're very fortunate indeed. And the score... Oh, 38.7 points. Oh, that's just a nice little moment, isn't it? Christopher Sacchin, the coach. And all credit to the Italian pairing of Elettra Neroni, Matilde Borello. Held on, but still managed to just sneak into the third place on the podium. Congratulations to the Italian. But look at the top. Jia Shen and Ruolin Yang, top of the bill. 330.75 points. Congratulations to the Chinese duo. It's the second gold medal for Jia Shen of Chengdu Sports University after she won gold in the women's 1 meter springboard final. She is, well, just a world-class diver. So happy for Yang Ruolin as well, the 23-year-old from Shandong Sports University, joining her on the podium to take a gold medal for herself. And how about the Malaysian pair? This is brilliant for Kimberly Bong. She's just back from 2 years of suffering with injuries, and now the 2023 has turned into her year with Ke Yingong, a silver medal here in Chengdu in this women's 3 meter synchronized springboard final. Congratulations once again, China, again with another gold medal, with Jia Shen, Ruolin Yang taking gold ahead of Malaysia, Kimberly Bong, and Ke Yingong. And Italy's Elettra Neroni, Matilde Borello. Congratulations.